Greetings, Benjamin J. the Victrola Guy, with another in the series. Well, if you've been following the series at all, you know over the past several months I've developed the Caniphonic Archivette, and then starting with that, the Caniphonic Recordette, which allows you to simply install the Recordette on your Edison home phonograph, play an MP3, M4A, streaming audio, whatever, directly to your cylinder, and begin making cylinder recordings at home. Rather high quality cylinder recordings directly from the archive, internet, anything you can find that will either supply you a downloadable MP3 or even just streaming audio. You can open it on your iPad or your iPhone or your computer, send the output directly to the Recordette, and then transfer that audio file directly to a cylinder. Been also developing other applications for this, and one I'm going to demonstrate to you right now. To my knowledge, this has never been done before, and it opens new possibilities for making fairly high-quality home recordings without all the hassle of recording on the Edison cylinder phonograph. It'll eliminate speaking tubes, it eliminates recording horns. It now allows you to make direct cylinder recordings using a microphone. And I'm going to demonstrate that to you right now. On the Edison Standard B, I have installed a shaved black wax cylinder, the Recordette. The Recordette is plugged into the amp, and so is the microphone. So for the very first time in the history of the Edison cylinder phonograph, I am going to make a direct cylinder recording using a microphone. So the machine's fully wound, we start the machine. As soon as I drop the stylus, the recording will begin. So the phonograph is now recording. Watch this. Greetings, Benjamin J. the Victrola Guy with another in the series. For the very first time in the history of the Edison cylinder phonograph, I am making a direct cylinder recording using a microphone. I have the microphone plugged into an amplifier. The amplifier is plugged into the Recordette, and the Recordette is mounted on the recorder on the Edison Standard B cylinder phonograph. So for the very first time in history, you can now make direct voice recordings using a microphone, just as you would with a tape recorder, a cassette tape recorder, or an MP3 recorder, or any recorder you have. But the interesting thing about it is that you no longer have to do acoustic recordings, unless you wish to. If you want to make a voice recording, you can simply use a microphone. Now, this is a new application. I haven't fully developed it yet, but it works, and it makes fairly good recordings. So now it's just a matter of tweaking this so it begins making outstanding cylinder recordings using a microphone. But just a quick demonstration of recording on the Edison cylinder phonograph in a new, completely new Caniphonic process. Using the Caniphonic Recordette, we are now able to make cylinder recordings using a microphone. I think this is quite a special day. As I said, to my knowledge, this has never been done before. So as always, if you have any questions or comments, please feel free to drop me an email, thevictrolaguy@gmail.com. I answer all of my email, try to answer the day I get it. I'm getting a lot of it now, and hopefully I'll be getting more as soon as I post this video. This is a very unique process, and it has never been done before. So as always, if you have any questions or comments, please feel free to drop me an email, thevictrolaguy@gmail.com, and as always, thank you for watching. Now we stop the machine, and we remove our cylinder, and as you can see, it is covered with swarf. So, using our swarf brush, we'll clean out these grooves. Now I'm going to play this on the Edison Home B through the brass Morning Glory horn. Give you some idea of the practical applications. Still developing it, but I wanted you to see the process and the fact that it's now possible to make these recordings on an Edison cylinder with a microphone. So we install the cylinder on the Edison Home B. Let me swing this camera around so you can see it. In fact, let me just move the camera over here. All right, I think that's probably close enough. All right, this is the recording we just made.
Greetings, Benjamin J. the Victrola Guy with another in the series. For the very first time in the history of the Edison cylinder phonograph, I am making a direct cylinder recording using a microphone. I have the microphone plugged into an amplifier. The amplifier is plugged into the recordette. The recordette is mounted on the recorder on the Edison Standard B cylinder phonograph. So for the very first time in history, you can now make direct voice recordings using a microphone, just as you would with a tape recorder, or a cassette tape recorder, or an MP3 recorder, or any recorder you have. But the interesting thing about it is that you no longer have to do acoustic recordings unless you wish to. If you want to make a voice recording, you can simply use a microphone. Now, this is a new application. I haven't fully developed it yet, but it works, and it makes fairly good recordings. So now it's just a matter of tweaking this so it begins making outstanding cylinder recordings using a microphone. But just a quick demonstration of recording on the Edison cylinder phonograph in a new, completely new cataphonic process. Using the cataphonic recordette, we are now able to make cylinder recordings using a microphone. I think this is quite a special day. As I said, to my knowledge, this has never been done before. So as always, if you have any questions or comments, please feel free to drop me an email, thevictrolaguy@gmail.com. I answer all of my email, try to answer the day I get it. I'm getting a lot of it now, and hopefully I'll be getting more as soon as I post this video. This is a very unique process, and it has never been done before. So as always, if you have any questions or comments, please feel free to drop me an email, thevictrolaguy@gmail.com. And as always, thank you for watching.